The way that we live our life makes a huge difference, you know? You talk, you reflect on those lives, and it changes you as a person. And it helps me the way my husband lived. He loved life, loved. I remember, like, we had so many appointments that we had to go, and he would have a taste and, you know, some kind of examination, and then we have to wait for the results. And there are times I went with him, and he loved, my husband loved to dress up nicely. He would wake up and put his shoe nicely. I would be like worried, my heart is just pumping. And I said to him one day, "Why are you so relaxed, you know?" And he said, "What do you want me to do?" What? He said, "Today we are going together. I'm thinking about where we are going to eat. You know, where I'm going to take you out today. That's what I'm thinking." I just laughed and I said, "You're too much, you know?" But he said, "What do you want me to do? Sit down and think about cancer? He said, how I'm going to die?" And I realized, Denise, I said to him, "You're right." He said, I'm alive, and look at me, I look good, you know? And we're good. You know, we are going to go out, you know? So that helped me personally, that, you know what? I'm alive, and there is a reason for me to still live. And, you know, I know that after all this, there is a purpose in my life, why I'm here, you know? I really wanted to die. Really, when Dave passed away, I was saying to God, "God, it would be for me comfortable just to be with him, beside him in the grave. That would be a comfortable place, you know? But God has a reason for me to be here. And I guess as hard as it is to live, you know, and you teach others also that by living, not by dying, because there are who would be affected, not only you.